of the best kept secrets of our ice hockey match nights is probably that of the role of the equipment manager. Today we're fortunate enough to talk with the Dundee Stars guy in charge of equipment, Kevin Ward, who's going to give us a short insight into his duties and perhaps enlighten us on a few of his favourite and fun moments with the Stars.
Typical home game, I would basically come in a night before, 2 hours before the match, and they prepared all the tops and the socks and the towels and their sweat towels as well, shower towels and the sweat towels, and they prepare the water bottles and make sure they've got enough pucks on the ice as well, and basically just make sure the boys have got everything they need. And the most important thing is Powerade. The guys like Powerade to keep up their strength during the, obviously the play of hockey. Well, the preparation time, if you're away on, say, a weekend fixture, then you basically have to come in, say, on a Friday evening, about an hour and a half, and prepare all the equipment, make sure they've got all the towels for the game, and we've got their tape and water set up as well, and their sticks are all ready as well, basically, for the game. Then you come in the next day, it's an hour before the bus comes, then make sure all the equipment's ready to go away. All the wee games.
This is what Scottish water we take with us when we're playing against the English. Because the guys like it, and so do I. And it's nice to get a nice Scottish cup of tea. Sorry, Swindle, but I know you're English. We'll still like you, but we'll like your Scottish water.
Yeah, well, the laundry, after the game when we come home after the double header, I'll come home and put all the laundry on, and all the stuff gets packed away, ready for the next game. The skates, Gordon Topman actually sharpens the skates. I'm in the process of getting trained, hopefully one day. Well, you start getting used to some of the size of the guys. There's all different heights and sticks, and guys tape them different ways, and them just used to the way they tape the sticks. And some of them do get numbered, but some guys prefer no numbers on their sticks. The biggest problem here away from home, especially as we're going away to Hull tomorrow, the dressing room is at the opposite side from where the bench is, so you've got a lot of preparing to make sure you've got a place for your drying your gloves, and there's power going to your gloves, and you've got to basically make sure you've got plenty of space for the guys in the changing rooms as well, because somebody take their bags out once they get their kit off to change, and just basically it's a bit different from Dundee. Because your changing room's right at your actual bench, but you've basically got to walk halfway around the ice rink. So there's a lot of preparing. There's actually one player like Dan, like the goalie, and he's basically, he has three sticks. One's a spare, goes on the bench, and he has two other sticks which you don't touch at all. One's in practice and one's his game stick. No, I've not got any stories at the moment. Come back to that maybe. Well, they make sure that the guys' sticks get repaired on match nights, and the gloves are all dry for the guys. It's a big help because when you're on away games, I get a hand from Sean, the bus driver, on a lot of away games, and he's a good help for giving us a hand out. He's not at most of the away games, so it's nice to be when you're at home, you actually get a hand, like with some of the kit. Andy Bell, he's a good help as well, Andy Bell. I've really got on well with Andy. We're like best of buddies. And on the long away trips like Cardiff or Sheffield, maybe midweek games or that, see, Andy will only go if I go with him, because I look after him and feed him.
Yeah.
I'm always giving them food. And I'm always buying McDonald's, Andy. I've only joked. I've been doing this 4 years now. The very first year I done it, there was obviously Brent Hughes was here. And it's a bit unusual before the start of a game, because the guy who's used to throw up about 2 or 3 times before the start of a match, just a bit nervous, but he's a good guy. So me and Andy used to have a bit of fun. How many times is he going to throw up? And have a wee bet?
You've not got that sort of problem this
year.
So
we don't have that problem this year.
No.
If everybody's better. I think this is about the best team, well, since I've been doing it, 4 years. The guys have really worked together. It's like one big happy family here. And the guys are going well, and I appreciate the job I do for them, which is a good help for me as well, when they appreciate. So the guys really missed me when I went. I took a week's holiday, and I missed about 4 games. And I didn't realise how much I was really missed when I came back. And when the game came in the changing room, and Dan gave us a big hug, went, "Don't leave me again." So it's nice to be like wanted, man. The same with Billy Bagron and Jeff Hutchins was really, they really miss me and they really appreciate me coming to the games. Well, the very first year when I started, like as 4 years ago, there was a great guy, Peter Cartwright. He was a really nice guy. I got on quite well with Peter Cartwright. And Mark Nebus, really nice guy. Dan Seaman, he was a really nice guy as well, before and after the game. That would be with the three pairs, yeah, players every light of that year.
Yeah,
and
the second year, that was the year Dan kind of left halfway through, didn't he?
Yeah, but I had Brent Hughes coming in and basically running the team. I got on quite well with Brent Hughes and AJ McQueen. It's a smashing guy, miss him, nice guy. And Jayla Tulip, he's a cracking wee player as well, for that year as well.
And last year?
Last year, Greg Muir, he's a nice guy, got in quite well with Greg Muir and Doug Grant as well. Had a few golfing trips with them, good fun, and Billy Bagron as well. But
This year,
we're
going to ask for favourites.
This year, I think all the team, basically, there's not any guys I would single out. I see that the other guys are actually smashing guys. And it's a privilege to sort of work with these sort of guys. I would say good success, and I would say Jeff Hutchins has got a cracking team together this year, and he should get some kind of award this year, hopefully.
Kev Ward, what's there to say about Kev Ward? Obviously, he's got a hard job, you know, it's his second job, he's got a full-time job, and, you know, it doesn't go unappreciated what he does for the guys, game days, travelling, you know. We really do appreciate everything he does. There is a little bit of a funny side to him. He's got some funny stories. Obviously, we'll keep that in the locker room. But we do appreciate it. You know, he's been 7 minutes, always helps the boys, gives us a wee laugh, you know. But as I said, his job's been much appreciated. You know, he works his bag off for the team, and we can't do it without him. So keep going, Kev.
Well, he's pretty hard to understand, so I don't know what he's saying half the time, but no, Kev's a great guy. Does a lot for the team, helps us out, you know, gets us going before every game with his 7-minute yell. And, you know, he's a huge part of this organization and, you know, a great guy. Respect him a lot and good friend.
And I went on holiday and he came back and they missed us.
Stolen.
No, it's not, is it?